markets with Scott Crothers and Steve Nicholas. Good morning, Scott.
Good morning, McGraw.
All right, how did we finish up yesterday?
Well, yesterday the Dow was up 6 points, closed at 23,563 in light trading. So far this earnings season, 87% of companies reported earnings and 75% have beaten their expectations. Now, we're seeing about 6.5% growth from the year-ago quarter, so it's looking like a great earnings season so far.
Good news. All very good news. Let's start with some companies. And what are we hearing from Apple?
Well, Apple, the world's most valuable public company, just passed $900 billion market cap, the first company to do so. It came after Apple reported some of the best earnings in 2 years on the strong demand for their new phones. Apple's market cap is bigger than 90% of the world's countries' GDP.
Mm. It's a good thing they ship their jobs overseas, so we can give them a tax cut. I'm sorry, did I say something? I'm sorry. Let's talk about Edgewell. What is Edgewell?
Edgewell is a St. Louis-based company. They make skincare, infant care, as well as shave cream and suntan lotion. And they reported a loss of $148.4 million on $564 million in revenue. For the full year, they had $2.3 billion in sales and made a profit of $5.7 million. And you'd never really heard of them.
Yeah, no, never heard of them until you sort of told us all about them. So we appreciate that. Shell, what's going on with gas these days?
Right. Well, Shell will make a new system for delivering and storing liquefied natural gas. The barge will hold 4,000 cubic meters of LNG and be able to take in liquid natural gas to store and refuel customers with LNG at the same time. It will serve marine customers along the East Coast, including cruise ships. This is great for all of us because liquefied natural gas is a cleaner burning energy source, and we have so much of it here in the U.S.
Hmm. Interesting. All right. And then will we continue our run today?
Well, not going to start off that way. The Dow right now looks off 75 points on the futures. We get a look at first-time jobless claims and also more earnings today. So hopefully they'll turn that around.
Scott Crothers, great for the insight. Appreciate it. We'll do it all again tomorrow. Thanks.
Sounds good.
6:43 here.